Okay, so I'm going to demonstrate how to group codes into clusters using individual based sorting strategy. So at the end, this is the kind of table that you're going to have. So you're going to have clusters, and it could be more than four clusters, right? You're going to have clusters, and each of the cluster will have its own column. And then under those clusters, you have the codes that have been sorted, right? So based on the similarities among them, they are grouped into various clusters. So that's how the final product is going to be after grouping codes into clusters. So let me start with the demonstration. So as you can see here, we have the codes that have been generated under the first research question, which is about the causes of burnout. And you can see that in parentheses, we have the code counts, which is the number of significant information connected to a specific code. And one thing that you have to think about is the more the number of significant information connected to a specific code, the more that code could be the dominant code, right? So as you can see here, because having numerous work-related tasks has four significant information connected to it, and compared to all of them, you see that it has the highest code count. So this, it's assumed that this code is the dominant code. So what you have to do is that when you are starting the sorting, you just start with the dominant code. It doesn't mean that if you start with any of the code, you will not be able to accurately sort the data. But to make things easy, you always think about starting with the dominant codes, and then you go ahead and then sort the other data, other codes that you have. So first of all, you have to create your table. So you go to Insert, and then you can create a table of about four columns or five columns. You want to come up with themes. So how many themes are you thinking about? Maybe you are thinking about six themes. You can start with five themes. You just have to be flexible. You don't have to have a lot of themes, right? At the end of the day, having five to maybe seven themes, that is fine. So in this demonstration, I'm just going to create a table with five clusters for now, right? So the first column will be cluster one, the second one will be cluster two, and we're going to have cluster three, cluster four, cluster five. Then you create a row under the cluster, and then you click on enter to open the row a little bit, because that's where it's going to put the code, right? So looking at the code that we have, as I said, you can start with the dominant one. So you copy having numerous work-related tags, and then drop it into the first cluster, right? And then, so what you're going to do is that now you have to make sure that you understand what having numerous work-related tasks mean, right? Because at the end of the day, you try to see whether you can find any code that have any connection with the same code here, so that you can bring them into one cluster. So that's all about the sorting, trying to see the similarities among the codes and then put them into the same cluster. So this one, we put the first one here, and then you can mark it to show that you have brought that code here, right? So that it's not be confusing to you, right? So after that, you can start with the first code and then go down onto the last code, right? So let's look at the first code. Being a young physician. Being a young physician was generated as one of the causes of burnout, right? And does it have anything with having numerous work-related tasks? I don't really think so. So you can put it in the second cluster because it doesn't have very close relationship with the first one. Let me copy that. I made a mistake here. So I copy and then I put it here. Right. So we have. So we highlighted to show that we have already brought that into the table, and then we look at the next one, feeling inadequate. Feeling inadequate might have, I don't know whether it might not have any relationship with having numerous work-related tasks, but I think because they are young, they feel like they are new to the system, so they feel they don't have all the needed skills to perform the work that has been given to them, right? So feeling inadequate can have some kind of relationship with the being a young physician. You are new to the system, you don't have much experience, and sometimes you may feel inadequate. So you see how there is a link between these two codes, so they can be in the same cluster. So let's go on and move to the next one. I have to make sure that I highlight it to show that I've already moved the code. So having long hours, having numerous work-related tasks. If you have numerous work-related tasks, there's high probability for you to also have a long hour. So there's some kind of connection between them. And at this stage, you have to be very flexible, because you may change your mind and then bring one of them to another cluster, right? But for now, this is where you think it could be located, right? Because it has some kind of link to having numerous work-related tasks. And then, so we highlight that, and then we move on to having trouble carrying out duties. Having trouble carrying out duties can be located. We can put them into the first cluster because I have some kind of relationship with the two codes that we have, having trouble carrying out duties, because there's a long, numerous work-related tasks, and also long hours. Numerous work-related tasks have something to do with having trouble finishing tasks, and then that can also lead to having long hours. So you see how there's some kind of link between these three codes. So that's how you're going to do. You just examine each of them and put them into their various classes. So at the end of the day, this is what you could, this will be the outcome, right? So you can see that we have put all the codes in the various clusters, and then we were able to put them into four clusters, right? So you always have to think about, can I put it in one of the existing clusters? If it has no relationship with any of the members in the cluster, then you can think about the other clusters that we have. If it has no relationship, then you can move on and create a new cluster, right? But as I said, at the end of the day, try not to go beyond 6-7 clusters, unless you have a lot of codes and you plan to do further categorization. So sometimes if you have, let's say you have about 40 codes, right? You can group them into maybe 15 clusters or maybe 10 clusters. Then after that, you can do further analysis and then analysis of each of the clusters and see whether you can combine those clusters. So the initial 15 clusters will be categories, and then you reanalyze those categories, and then you come up with themes. At this stage, we don't have to have categories because we have only four clusters. So these clusters will be called themes. But the next step is to label the clusters, right? Based, and the label should reflect the members, the cluster members, right? The cores that are under the cluster. But we will talk about it in detail in our next lesson. So I hope you are clear in terms of the grouping the cores into various clusters, right? So that's how it's done. If you are using a software, you could do that in the system, the software. But the easier way that I've seen is that after developing codes using the software, you can download all the codes and then manually sort the codes that you have using this, the steps that I've shown you, demo demonstration. You have to create a table and then put them into various clusters, and then when you end the process by coming up with themes, you can go back and put the themes back into the system or the software that you are using, right? So this step is very important for you to gain a skill in sorting codes into clusters. That will be very helpful for you to gain and practice. As I said, you have to be flexible in this process because sometimes you may decide to move a code from a specific cluster to another cluster, and maybe after reanalyzing or re-examining the cluster members, you realize that one of the code doesn't belong there, so you can move into another one, right? So that is how we do the sorting. So thank you.